हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द टॉपिक टाइम सीरीज. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ टाइम सीरीज. द फर्स्ट वन सेक्युलर ट्रेंड, द सेकेंड वन सीजनल वेरिएशंस वी आर डिस्कस्ड. ओके, इन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द अदर टू कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ टाइम सीरीज. स्टूडेंट्स, the third one is cyclical variation. It is also called as business cycle. Students, most of economic and business time series are influenced by the wave-like changes of prosperity and depression. There is a periodic up and down movements. This movement is known as cyclical variation or oscillatory variation. So, see students, this can be defined by cyclical variation is an oscillatory variation which occurs in four stages, namely first one prosperity, second one recession, third one depression, fourth one improvement. So, what do you mean by cyclical variation or business cycle? Cyclical variation is an oscillatory variation which occurs in four stages. First one is prosperity, second stage recession, third one depression, and the fourth one improvement. Students, this always happens in four stages only. Okay, the example, most business and economic time series are influenced by wave-like changes. Okay, students, this can be represented by diagrammatically. See the diagram. So this is diagrammatic representation of business cycle. Observe this diagram. See, so this straight line is normal line. See, there is a curve here. This curve is like this. So how any business it faces four stages. See, the first stage is prosperity. It is in the good form. Later, suddenly there is a recession or decline. Because of recession, third stage is depression. Then the fourth one, after depression, there is an improvement or the recovery. Okay. So like this, in the business field, the variations are going on. Students, this business cycle is very, very important. This can be asked many times with diagrammatically how to represent like this. Okay, so always it occurs in four stages: prosperity, recession, depression, and improvement. Okay, students, the study of cyclical variation is helpful to businessmen and economists for framing suitable policies and stabilizing the level of business statistics. Okay, so let us see the fourth component, that is irregular variation. It is also called as random or erratic variation. So what do you mean by irregular variation? The sudden or unexpected variations in a time series is called irregular or random variation. What do you mean by irregular variation? The sudden or unexpected variations in a time series is called irregular or random variation. For example, sudden increase in death rates of a locality due to earthquakes or floods, tsunami, etc. So these are unexpected things. Sudden increase in the death rate of a locality due to earthquake or floods or tsunami, etc. The second example for irregular variation is sudden increase in the price of vegetables due to bond call given by an organization. Right? There is a notice here, students, important note. Irregular variations are caused by wars, floods, strikes, earthquakes, and tsunami, etc. So it is very, very important, students. So this can be asked many times. So what are the causes for irregular variations? Why the irregular variations is happen, right? So the causes for irregular variations are wars, floods, strikes, earthquakes, tsunami, etc. Right? The second note is, students, these movements are very irregular and unpredictable. So irregular variations are unpredictable, very important. And students, after this, methods of measuring secular trend. So to measure the secular trend, we have some of the methods. Total we have 4 methods to measure the trend. The first one is graphical method, second one semi averages method, and the third one moving averages method, the fourth one least squares method. Okay, students, to measure the secular trend we have 4 methods to measure the trend. The first one is graphical method. Through graph we are going to measure the trend. And this is semi averages method. Third one, moving averages method. The fourth one, least square method. Students, will study one by one in detail. So the first one is graphical method. It is also called as freehand method. In this method, original data will be plotted on the graph. Draw a smooth line or curve carefully, which will show the direction of the trend. So graphical method or freehand method is, in this method, original data will be plotted on the graph. Draw a smooth line or curve carefully, which will show the direction of the trend. So this means the first method is, through graphically we are going to measure the trend, right? The second method is semi-averages method. In this method, the original data is divided into 2 equal parts and averages are calculated for both the parts. These averages are called semi-averages. Questions, how this method is calculated? So in this method, the original data is divided into 2 equal parts. First, the original data can be divided into 2 equal parts. After making the 2 equal parts, averages are calculated for both the parts. These averages are called semi averages. Students, problems, let us solve example on semi averages. The first question is, obtain trend values by the method of semi averages. Question is, students, in the first column, year is given from 2008 to 2013. The next row, value is given 100, 120, 110, 130, 120 and 140. Okay, students, with this question we have to apply semi averages method, then solve the example. Students, before solving, so what is the procedure to solve this semi averages method? So first method is, students, we have to make the 2 equal parts. This original data can be divided into 2 equal parts. So then first count, how many values are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 values are there. So this can be divided into 2 equal parts as 3, 3. Okay, solution. So after making the 2 equal parts, right? So from 2008 to 2010, this is one part. And from 2011 to 2013, this is one part. After dividing these 2 equal parts, take the average of these 2 parts. First, I will take the average of the first part, 100 plus 120 plus 130. So 100 plus 120 plus 110 divided by 3. So after adding these 2 values divided by 3, by taking this average, so the value is 110. Again, you take the second group, right? Add these values. So 130 plus 120 plus 140 divided by 3. After taking this group, the average is 130. So this one is 110, this one is 130. 30. Okay, students. So how to find this one? Obtained trend values by method of semi averages. First, we have to make two groups. Here, total 6 values are there. How to make a two group? 3-3 group we are did, right? So this is one group from 2008 to 2010, and this is one group from 2011 to 2013. After making the group, you take the average of first group. So the average of first group is 110. The average of second group is 130. Students, let us take the second example on semi averages. Obtain trend values by the method of semi averages. So year from 2012 to 2018 is given. Value 10, 20, 15, 30, 25, 20, 36. Students, again, the first step is you have to make two groups. So first count the values. How many values are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Students, here 7 numbers are there. So this means how to make the two equal parts. Here there is an odd number. See students, in odd number, how to make the two equal parts? This, the middle year, 2015, you have to left out, right? You have to left this 2015. If you left, this means again you have to get 3-3 groups. From 2012 to 2014, one group, you leave this middle value, that is 2015. Second group from 2016 to 2018, again second group, okay? So after leaving this middle one, 2015, add these three values. 10 plus 20 plus 15 divided by 3 is 15. And the second group, 25 plus 20 plus 36. After adding these three values, divided by 3 is 27. Okay, students, with this, so I'm going to stop here only. In the next class, students, I'm going to solve the examples on graphical method and the method of moving averages. Thank you, students.